It is for sure a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Oh, welcome back. It is good being able to give you the latest and greatest update. Oh my gosh, this is October's YL 2021 update. Here we go.
You're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps, you are to me.
For those of you who don't know me, my name is Sly Williams. I am an air director on the east end of Pittsburgh. And I've been on staff with Young Life for almost 4 years. And man, it's been a whirlwind. It's been so much fun. It's been chaotic, but it's been all joyful. And it's an opportunity to be used by Christ. And so I've been living on the east end with my beautiful smoking hot wife, Amy Williams, and our beautiful baby boy, Phoenix. And man, they are just the biggest cheerleaders. Now, with that being said, anything else, I do usually a monthly vlog or an update, if you will. It's just a great way, I think, for you guys to see what I get to do, what I get to experience on a monthly basis. And sometimes that consists of just being with kids. And there's other times where I've had partnerships that we're establishing. And so it just goes to show the progression. If you ever get the opportunity to look back at any of my older videos, especially when I first moved here from like the hypotheticals to where we are today, it is absolutely profound and remarkable. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. So this has been an exciting month. October has been a lot of fun, really just because I get to hang out with a lot of kids. As you just saw, that was my man Mike and Yoel and Kalu, and they're just hanging out, just kicking it. And down in Oakland, you know, it was one day after cross country practice, and I said, yo man, like, let's go grab some ice cream. And it was just, for them, it was like everything in a sense, just to be able to hang out down Oakland and just relax was a lot of fun. But those small moments turn into huge opportunities, and also them understanding that community isn't very important. It can really shape and help shift the trajectory of somebody's life. Now, I've been able to get into the school for lunches, which has been great. Just the rapport that's been established in the last almost 4 years. And so I emailed the principal and he allowed me to come to lunches. And so this is the first lunch that I've been to since school started. And I walk in and the Marines were there and they were doing a pull-up contest. And so check it out.
Eli, he with the Marine right here. We about to get this in. Here we go. Pull-ups. What we got? First push-ups, now pull-ups. Yeah.
One.
One.
Two.
You gotta kiss the ceiling.
Three. Four.
All right, well, my man Eli, we just got done doing the pull-up. You know what I'm saying? How many did you do total? 35, right?
30, yeah.
How many did I do? 21.
Yeah,
and you got a shirt from me. You know what I'm saying? That's what we do over here. We support one another. Here we go. I see you.
Let's go, Mason. He about to beat Eli real quick. Oh yeah, he got that. One, two. Oh yeah, he got that. Three. Hey, come on, beat Eli. Come on.
12.
Come on, you got three more.
Come on now.
13.
Come on.
14.
Oh yeah, you got this. Come on. Oh yeah, come on. Yo, get 16, beat Eli.
Let's go, let's go.
Beat Eli.
Let's go.
16, let's go. Yeah, Eli, take that.
Now, as you can see, you saw a couple of the guys doing pull-ups, and then I was trying to hold out. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I was trying to hold out, but there was a shirt online for if you did 20 pull-ups. My man Eli tried, and he could not hit it, and so I was like, you know what? I'll go for it. I'll try it. I was successful in that, and I was able to give that shirt to Eli, but it was just a lot of fun to get back into the lunchroom. It's really a sweet, undistracted time. I mean, technically kids are like running around everywhere, but they really can't go anywhere else. They're just in the lunchroom. And so it's so much better than dismissal, because dismissal kids are, they're on a mission to get to wherever they need to be, whether it's a sport or getting back home or going to a meeting, where at lunch is just an opportunity to just hang out, sit down with them and relax. So that has been very fruitful and has created new relationships and just meeting new kids. And what I would say has been really a highlight of it all is kids that I know introduced me to other kids, which is great, because like the word of Young Life is getting out, but overall, hopefully it's really the light of Christ that's being shown and being caught by other kids. So that's been so much fun. And so as these relationships grow, or the introductions turn into more of a friendship or just getting to know one another, I love to invite them into what we call campaigns, which is like Bible discussion, like Bible study. It's an opportunity for kids that usually throughout their days are, you know, they feel like they're being always being told what to do. It's an opportunity for us to talk about, to open up God's word, but then also ask them, hey, what do you think about this? What stands out to you? And I just love that. I just love it. And we get to mix it up. We play some games. Sometimes we eat some food. And this is one moment where we got the opportunity to actually break bread. And we had wing night, but we also got a new office. And so we were playing ping pong. And, you know, just check this out.
Dang!
Young blood.
We got a very serious game of ping pong. Cinderella story. Coming back from nowhere. Frozen tundra. Johnny. Against Nicholas and Kalu. Dun, dun, dun.
Out.
Now, most of these guys, I don't know if they've ever played ping pong, but if they have, they're not that great at it. But I just love exposing them to just new things to try. I always tell them, get out of your comfort zone. And especially at campaigners, it's just a way for kids to just know that they are safe, they're protected, and there's no, you know, dumb answers or dumb questions. And it really does set them up for, you know, next steps in life, whether they're interviewing at for a job or even for college. It just allows them to engage more with one another and also be more intentional about what they say, and also that they have the freedom to think about different things and might not always agree on certain things as well, and also have space and room to hear new perspectives and hopefully learn and apply to their lives. So campaigners has been really a joy. I try to run that on a weekly basis, but it all depends on what's going on. Sometimes we turn that into just going out and getting something to eat, just to get kids out of their rut of playing video games all day or just staying in the house and doing nothing. So if there's a beautiful day like this, as you can see, the sun is out, it's beautiful, I try to like get them out and just opt outside and just they'd see God's natural, raw beauty. And it's a great conversation piece to talking about how good he is and how he's created us for a reason, for a purpose.
Let's go, Ruthie.
These kids are not playing this year. We are on route to taking both boys and girls to states this year. This hasn't happened in almost 6 years. We've been taking girls individually and boys have been going as a team, but this is gonna be the first time possibly where we take both boys and girls to states, and they've been moving and grooving. They are so strong. They're a young team as well, but they just get it. Like, they're hungry for it. They've been asking the right questions. And when it even comes to nutrition, they've been cutting back on eating a lot of the snacks that they probably eat, but also when it comes to the workouts that have been provided by Coach Flynn, they've just been stepping up. And I mean, it's encouraging to hear about this, but when you're at these practices, it's not that much fun to run at them, because they're killing me right now. So I'm actually excited as cross country is actually coming into an end. You just head into regionals and then we'll be getting ready by states. By the time you see this video, states will have been completed. But it's been such a great time, a great season to see where we were at in August with so many new freshmen and them doubting themselves to now fast forward 2 months or so ahead. And now they're a lot more confident, but also encouraging and uplifting to other students that have joined the team later on. So cross country will always have a sweet spot in my heart. Just love the kids, love the coaching, and just how we get to put on for the city. You know, we are hopefully seated to be top 10 at states, and so as long as we stay healthy, or as long as they stay healthy, we hopefully will take at least top 10 and look forward to growing with the team in the next few years.
Won't fit in there.
Whoa, watch your shoulder.
She's so thoughtful.
We do need a freshman photo with the boys.
Yeah, I heard you were in here.
No, we should take a freshman photo and then take another one senior year.
No, I think he has it.
No, I think just.
Okay, this is all I already have for this month, this beautiful month of October. I mean, the season itself, and I mean, from September to even now, it's been fairly warm. I mean, I'm still moved by going out and seeing the different colors of the trees, but also having the sun still on us. And so I don't want to take that for granted, because when that cold comes, oh, it's going to come. But overall, it's been such a joy being in Pittsburgh this past year. And as we get ready for the winter, we also come with some new cool things. We got fall weekend coming up. You guys can be praying for that. We really look forward to taking a solid amount of kids to fall weekend. Hopefully we'll take like 20 kids. And it's just a great way for them to get removed from distractions and once again have room to process, contemplate things that are going on in life, but also get them away from some hard things going on at home. And once again, knowing that they're in a place where they're safe, they're in comfort, and they're in love is ultimately the heart of why we do Fall Weekend. But they also get to have fun too. They get a reminder of what it feels like to just be a kid. Not have to worry about work, not have to worry about hardships going on at home, not to worry about schoolwork, just being a kid on a weekend and getting to meet other kids from all over the metro. So you can pray for Fall Weekend that there's a great attendance, not even just in numbers, but that the kids that are there, they seriously do feel cared for. You can be praying for the family. Once again, as we move into, we're still in this really busy season. It's an abundant season too. It's not just busy, but it's abundant, and we don't want to miss those opportunities. So just be praying for Amy, praying for Knicks, especially as they support me. There are definitely nights or moments where I had to step out, and they are so supportive. And so be praying for us that we get back into a rhythm where we can put our heads back up and be thankful and be appreciative that we were in this journey, in this race together. You can pray for leaders. There's just a lot, the new transitions, people getting married, you know, Becca's getting married, Spencer's graduating early, Sarah's gonna be graduating soon, George just got a new job. So you can be praying for the leaders we have, but also pray for new spaces, new leaders to be added to the team, because we have over 1,400 students that gather at Tell Older Dice. And so us four, I mean, we love these kids and we'll go after them. The reality is we're going to need more leaders as well. And so we need more people to stand up, to step up and be unashamed to proclaim the gospel and just love kids exactly where they're at. Some of these kids is wild. And, you know, you got to come with tough skin. But overall, they are life-giving. It is life-giving to serve them and to allow them to know that they're loved. Just like the same way we need to receive God's love, we get to do that for them. And so that's always a blessing. Anything else? Just pray for myself. Pray that I lead well, that I lead out of wisdom, godly wisdom, not worldly wisdom. Lord knows I need that on a daily basis, that I don't forget my purpose, that I don't forget the reason why I said yes to being an air director. It's not because of the flexibility. It's not because I get to be a cool, I'm not even saying I'm cool, but you know, people think that about me, that I'm not no cool guy that just walks into the school, but that I really come walking with the power of Christ. And I want to remember that as I walk into that school and know that we can blow the doors off the hinges. If I said that right, hinges off the door, doors off the hinges. That's right. I really do believe that. And this year has really spoke that, especially as we come out of a pandemic where kids were online for almost a year and a half, there is a sense and a posture of appreciation. And I want to be appreciative that I get to spend time with these kids as well. And so you can be praying for myself, pray for the area. Okay, that's all I really have. I mean, I could go on and on, but I just want to kind of keep this one a little bit shorter, get ready. So the next update will be November, December, because as we close out the year, I want to give you guys a little bit of a break for your Thanksgiving. So be thinking of what are things you're thankful for, what's putting a smile on your face these last couple of weeks. You know, be thinking about those type of things. And then also Christmas, a very important time as well. So that's all I got. If you haven't heard from anyone else, please hear from me. I truly do mean this. This is not just fluff. You have meaning, you have value, you have purpose. I got to get out of here. I'm going to enjoy the rest of this day. I hope you do as well. Peace.